Thank you. What? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Respond. Thank you. Thank you. Right.
Ah, there we go. Sorry about that.
Hi. Hey, there you are. GG, my friend. Well played.
Thank you.
So, about this scene.
It's always fun doing all Dungeons Key Sanity. I just like it when you know that up front, at least.
So, this was one of those rare beasts of the Aghanim 1 pedestal combo.
Honestly, after I saw what was in the Lumberjack Cave, I was expecting Pedestal to have a Castle Tower key.
No, of course, those were both inside of Pendant Ice Palace.
Which, thankfully for me, I didn't realize it was a pendant at the time, so I was just going into full clear.
Right. Pretty sure everybody... Like, I'm pretty sure everyone just did that because they didn't know what Ice Palace was. They're just like, well, we're here. So, with Book and Misery Meyer, that was an absolutely required blind pull of the flute on the pedestal. And here we were thinking, in like 15 minutes in, that the seed was going to just give you everything.
Yeah, at first it was starting to seem nice, and then I started realizing, okay, I need three keys and the flute. I need two keys and the flute. Where's my flute?
Actually, I cut in for one quick second. Ice Blue has come in third and overall with an official editorial time of 2 hours, 14 minutes, and 13 seconds. So let's get some GGs for Ice Blue, please. And back to you for Luminelli.
Indeed.
Yeah, that flute was a thing for sure.
I won't lie. I went to blind pull it expecting, okay, you're just going to be a single green rupee just to toy with me.
And we also do have X Blue in chat with us. GG, Ice Blue, well played.
GG.
That was a seed.
That was definitely a seed.
Yeah. So, which surprised you more, finding Bo in Lumberjack or blind pulling the flute?
Blind pulling the flute, most definitely.
Yeah.
I really, really need to learn Hammer Yump. As you guys witnessed, I've failed like 20 times because I only had 4 keys and I was trying to save that last key just to go down to Helmasaur, and I couldn't get it, and had I have gotten it, I probably would have saved myself probably like 8 minutes.
It's all right, man. That is a hard thing to get down.
It's 2 pixel perfect bomb placements, so
yeah, you know, just 2. Yeah, no, that was very unfortunate, but still, I would be exceptionally happy with 2 hours, 14 minutes on a seed that required both Aga 1 and the pedestal. Nearly 100%ed.
Yeah, that was just, my routing that seed was just really bad. I should have, like, I had flippers, and I did not go to Pyramid after checking, like, the thing next to Sanctuary in Dark World, and go and check, like, the stuff on Zora's side. I didn't go grab Hammer, which that would have involved me not having to double dip Ice Palace, which was a bad thing.
Vitasia has decided to toss and towel, so let's get some GGs in chat for Vitasia. Heck of a risk by him as well. Just a couple trill items, unfortunately, with the bow being Aghanim 1 locked.
Indeed.
I saw bow Aga 1 locked pretty early, and then when I got Ice Palace's two Castle Tower keys, I was just like, wow, yeah. Okay, we're going to get bow now.
Right, yeah. Yeah, Vitasia unfortunately did not check Lumberjack Cave for a very long time.
Yikes. I always make it a point to check that. I've had Bo in there before. It was pretty, pretty bad.
What's it now?
Yeah, that Bo. What?
Yeah.
What?
Hey, Vitasia, well played, my friend. Just a rough seed.
out of curiosity, I felt like my early game routing was doing pretty good, and I pulled that moon pearl out of thin air. But it all kind of just fell apart because I never checked Lumberjack Ledge, huh?
Your assessment is very correct.
So how about that blind pull?
Oh my god! I just did the blind pull like 5 seconds ago, and I'm like, it has to be it. There's literally nothing. And then, you know, there are the little one-off places like, oh, I never checked Dig Game. What the heck? Or I never did this, and I got the one key to Turtle Rock. And I'm like, okay, then Trinex is going to have dropped something after I've already been in there. No, it's like I played my early game perfect, and then like after I started having to cherry pick places, I was done.
It seemed like the kind of seed that just was like, here you go, they have all this really nice, lovely stuff in the first 15 minutes. Then we're going to kick you in the pants.
Right, so before the race started, like, Dark and I were calling off items that we expected to be trolling everybody here. As much as we're like, yeah, the bow, that's always the bow, so it's not going to be the bow this time. Turns out, every item we thought was going to troll you guys found in the first 15 minutes. I predicted Fire Rod. That was located really quick. Dark here predicted the Hookshot. That was found really quick.
It gave you a bunch of generous items.
Yeah, and I thought the Thieves Town Big Key was going to be a thing. You guys found that immediately. Not immediately, but, you know, pretty quick. And then, as it turns out, the two items that were really hard to locate were two Castle Tower big keys, or small keys.
Yeah, there for a while, I didn't feel too bad about not... I mean, I went into the Castle Tower, and then I realized, you know, oh, wait, Lumberjack Ledge could be something, so I had to go back in there. But, like, okay, the two Castle Tower keys, I think, were both at Ice Palace. So, yeah. I didn't feel too bad about the not doing Lumberjack... until it was not only an aga required lumberjack ledge but also a blind pedestal pole for flute, which was your access to both desert and Misery Mire.
Yes, because guess where the book was? The book was in Misery Mire.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Where? Okay, so the two things that I'm missing yet are the Desert Palace Big Key and Ganon's Tower Big Key.
So Desert Palace Big Key was in Misery Mire. No, the Misery Mire shed. Ganon's Tower Big Key was in Misery Mire.
Alright, so I'm only about 20 minutes away from being done anyway from the seed.
This seed reminds me of that Z1 race we had yesterday, Faust. I think.
Yeah, just a bit.
I think you were in it. Level 7, right?
Yeah, I never want to hear level 7 again. Anyway. So good luck. Good game to all four of you. That was a heck of a race. Best of luck next week to all four of you as well. Looking at the schedule going forward, we do have a full docket for the rest of the night. 9 p.m. and just about a little over a half hour from now, we do have two races going on. We have one on Speed Gaming between ACMLM and TGH on one screen, and Sir Peter of Arse versus He's Just a Boy. Then on A Link to the Past Randomizer 3, we'll have Big Dunka versus Bright Wolves and Shrink89 versus Freda. That will be on A Link to the Past Randomizer 3. Also at 9 p.m., we will have Chloe Power versus Tim Lebo on A Link to the Past Randomizer 4. Then at 10 p.m., we have another quad match between Invictus 2011 versus Mabel 1904. And along with them, we'll have Pokedude 14 versus F. Coughlin. At 11 p.m., we'll have Maximum Barnage versus Brewers Fan JP. And that'll be on A Link to the Past Randomizer 1. And then closing out the night on Speed Gaming will be Solidus SRL versus Who42 Baker. So we have a ton of matches left tonight, and we have a full docket on the schedule for tomorrow. Any final words before we close out from any of the runners?
Just GG Prior. You played the seed pretty good. I think the double dip into Pod and double dip into Ice Palaces would put me 14 minutes behind you.
But yeah, thanks, and I hope you'll do best the next rounds and maybe getting in the final bracket.
Hope so. Good luck to your next race, too.
Thanks. Best luck to you.
Okay, and with that, I do want to give a quick shout-out to our behind-the-scenes crew. We got Liam Atlas on the tracker tonight, along with Cyclone GU and Rarara Dragu, all doing some fantastic tracking for us behind the scenes. Please give them all a follow. Please give all of our runners a follow. Liminality, Prior 57, Vitasia, and X Ice Blue. Please give all of them a follow for a heck of a race with a lot of fun. And of course, please follow my co-commentating partner today, OPT Lawyer.
Of course, follow Darkfells over here. He's been an awesome partner today. Great, great race and everyone. Very fun to watch. Really rough seed. Absolutely disgusting at times. So good play it, everybody.
Make sure you go watch Fowl's VODs and then go make comments about that level 7 from Z1 last night.
No. Okay, so with that, I was Darkfells 1983. Today with me was OPT Lore. Everyone, we'll see you back here in about 35 minutes for another race. Until then, we'll see you on the next show. Have a great night, everyone.